وبعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وإلى مدين أخاهم شعيبا فقال يا قوم اعبدوا الله وارجوا اليوم الآخر ولا تعثوا في الأرض مفسدين. فكذبوه فأخذتهم الرجفة فأصبحوا في دارهم جاثمين. وعادا وثمود وقد تبين لكم من مساكنهم وزين لهم الشيطان أعمالهم فصدهم عن السبيل وكانوا مستبصرين. وقارون وفرعون وهامان ولقد جاءهم موسى بالبينات فاستكبروا في الأرض وما كانوا سابقين. فكلا أخذنا بذنبه فمنهم من أرسلنا عليه حاصبا ومنهم من أخذته الصيحة ومنهم من خسفنا به الأرض ومنهم من أغرقنا. وما كان الله ليظلمهم ولكن كانوا أنفسهم يظلمون. مثل الذين اتخذوا من دون الله أولياء كمثل العنكبوت اتخذت بيتا وإن أوهن البيوت لبيت العنكبوت لو كانوا يعلمون. إن الله يعلم ما يدعون من دونه من شيء وهو العزيز الحكيم. وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس وما يعقلها إلا العالمون. خلق الله السماوات والأرض بالحق إن في ذلك لآية للمؤمنين. صدق الله العظيم. وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين. والحمد لله رب العالمين. Surah An-Kabut. Last time we had read about the people of Lut ala Nabiyyina Salatu Wassalam. A few points of understanding that Hazrat Hakeemul Ummat Maulana Shaykh Sadat Thani Rahmatullah Alayhi has mentioned in his famous book Masail al-Suluk under the ayat that we did last time. When Hazrat Lut Alayhi Salam said Rabbin Surni ala al-Qawm al-Mufsideen, Hazrat Lut Alayhi Salam and other Anbiya have also made bad-dua or invoked the wrath of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala over their people. And this tells us that it is permissible that to rid oneself of the constant persecution by people, one can invoke the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah destroys a nation because of their transgression, therein some ulama have written that there is mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not destroy them at that time, then their sins would have kept on amassing and their punishment would have kept on increasing. قَالَ إِنَّ فِيهَا لُوطًا. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam said to the angels that the town that you are going to destroy, there is loot in there. This tells us that this is proof from the Quran that when there is good people in a community, they are a source of protection for that community. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, our Nabi, he has also told us that people are saved because of the people, a few people among them, if they cry because of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the whole community is saved because of such people. Two times in the story of Hud alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned his wife as imra'ata or imra'atak. So Allah is not telling us the name, Allah is not telling us that there is a woman who lives in your house. Allah is saying your wife or his wife. And twice Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned that she would be punished. She would be among the general people who are being punished or the ones who stay behind and therefore be annihilated with the people. This tells us that close relationship, even such a close relationship as being the spouse of a pious person without iman, without faith, is of no benefit. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the right understanding. Today we recited these ayat, وَإِلَىٰ مَدْيَنَ أَخَاهُمْ شُعَيْبًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning a few other anbiya. To Madian, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent their brother Shu'ayb. فَقَالْ, he said, يَا قَوْمْ, O my people, اُعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَرْجُ الْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ. وَرْجُ الْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ. O people, worship Allah and fear the last day. وَلَا تَعْثَوْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُفْسِدِينَ and do not roam about the land as mischief makers. So these people, they used to not only do kufr and shirk, but also do not fulfill the rights of people either by weighing, cheating in their weights and their measurements. فَكَذَّبُوهُ So they gave a lie to Hud, Shu'aib. فَأَخَذَتْهُمُ الرَّجْفَةُ فَأَصْبَحُوا فِي دَارِهِمْ جَاثِمِينَ Then they were seized by the earthquake and they remained in their homes lying on their faces. وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمْ وَعَادًا وَثَمُودًا And عَاد and ثَمُود وَقَدْ تَبَيَّنَ لَكُمْ مِنْ مَسَاكِنِهِمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also destroyed عَاد and ثَمُود and it is visible to you through their dwellings. So the people of Arab, when they used to go to Sham, all these, most of these nations, numerous of them, their abodes, they could see. وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَعْمَالَهُمْ فَصَدَّهُمْ عَنِ السَّبِيلِ وَكَانُوا مُسْتَبْصِرِينَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that Shaitan had beautified for them their deeds, so he prevented them from the right way, even though they were a people of insight. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that even though someone might be the people of Aad were very smart in terms of their technology, in terms of their understanding and the working of the world, and we've read in different books of history that some of the technologies that they had, we cannot even imagine today. Anyway, but Allah is saying that they were smart people, but Shaitan had beautified their deeds for them, so he led them astray. So smartness does not benefit a person. The real smartness is to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Nabi of the time. Otherwise, the understanding of a person leads them into the wrong direction. The smartness of a person leads them into the wrong direction. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. So today as well, people are very smart, people are intellectuals, but that does not mean that they can be leaders of deen. For somebody to be a leader of deen, they have to be a very pious, very Allah-fearing person, and a person who does good deeds rather than just being smart and thinking that I am smart and I can figure out my own way. وقارون وفرعون وهامان قارون we recently read about him, فرعون and هامان these are all from the people of فرعون and the challenge of Musa عليه السلام. هامان was his wazir or his minister. قارون was also a rich person in the time of Musa عليه السلام. ولقد جاءهم موسى بالبينات had Musa عليه السلام had indeed come to them with clear signs فاستكبروا في الأرض they acted arrogantly on the earth وَمَا كَانُوا سَابِقِينَ And while they were doing it, they were showing their arrogance, but they did not know that they could never be able to escape Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or run away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the people of Makkah or to the living, these people are examples. Whoever in the future as well, they think that they are arrogant, they are strong, they are smart, none of that works. The only thing that matters is, does one submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not, listen to their Nabi or not. If not, then all these past people, they were seized by the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِ Thus we seized each one of them for their sin or for his sin. فَمِنْهُمْ So among them, مَنْ أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِ حَاصِبًا Some of them we sent a violent wind. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَخَذَتْهُ الصَّيْحَةُ And some of them were seized by a cry. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ خَسَفْنَا بِهِ الْأَرْضِ And some of them we made to sink in the earth. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَغْرَقْنَا And some of them we drowned in the water. وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيَظْلِمَهُمْ And Allah was not to do injustice to them. وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ But they used to do injustice to their own selves. مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ كَمَثَلِ الْعَنْكَبُوتِ The example of the people who take friends and patrons thinking that they will help them apart from Allah. Their example is like the ankabut, spider. اتخذت بيتا that makes a house. That makes a house of itself. وَإِنَّ أَوْهَنَ الْبُيُوتِ لَبَيْتُ الْعَنْكَبُوتِ And while indeed the weakest of the houses is the house of the spider, that even a fast blowing wind can blow away the house. But the spider itself, when it is making that house, it works so hard and it makes a house that she thinks it thinks that it's a very strong house. The people who take partners to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and thinking that they will help, they are like the houses of the spider, that the spider builds that house thinking it will help it, it will save it, but the strong wind blows and it blows away. لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ Only if they knew. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ مِن شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ Surely Allah knows whatever they invoke besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وهو العزيز الحكيم. He is the Almighty. He is the All-Wise. وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس. And these are the examples that Allah Subhanahu wa Taala gives for people. All these examples, people of Aad, Thamud, people of Hud, Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, Lut alayhi salam, the Firaunis, all of them, and the example of the house of the spider. All of these are examples that Allah gives. وَمَا يَعْقِلُهَا إِلَّا الْعَالِمُونَ. But only nobody understands them except the alimun, the knowledgeable people. Therein is the definition of alim as well. The alim is that person who takes instruction and fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rather than just having plain knowledge of the book or learning of the book. رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. We completed, alhamdulillah, except for one ayah, completed the 20th juz. Next time, inshallah, we'll start the 21st. All of these videos are also available on YouTube. So if somebody wants to follow from, alhamdulillah, from Surah Fatiha all the way up to here, they are recorded and they are available. And inshallah, they will be a good source of understanding for anybody who wants to use it. رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَلَى خَيْرِ خَلْقِهِ سَيِّدِنَا وَمَوْلَانَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ أَجْمَعِينَ. آمين بِرَحْمَتِكَ يَا أَرْحَمَ الرَّاحِمِينَ.